actually, yeah, this is five. So, yeah.
Yeah, let's definitely get some footage in here and see what's
going on.
You're everybody's favorite flavor.
Apparently. Well, now I'm pulled out for Wednesday. Like, it doesn't take long.
That's awesome, though. We're going to definitely check out your podcast.
It's at the top of your data page.
Everybody okay.
Asks, so I just leave it at
yeah,
the top.
Yeah, we'll have to check it out.
Everybody asks.
Trying to do your other thing, you got family, and trying to do this, I mean, it wears on you for sure.
Well, even dealing with this all the time,
right.
Like coming out here and remembering
then
all
you
the
got, right, and then you got all the back processing you have to do, and that's a lot.
So I'm up till 1:30 in the morning, trying to get all this stuff processed for you guys
right.
In the morning, so when I get up with that first cup of coffee, I can get started on reviewing it.
Right.
And then I'm usually, I try to be done by noon, but if I have a problem, or, you know, the upload didn't go properly, I gotta fix it. And
right.
I gotta write all the notes up. And I have to listen to the like, that goes into
yeah.
This.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Again, noon, 1 o'clock is usually when I'm done. And I usually start about 7 or 8. So,
yeah. You're going nonstop.
I have
you got the same schedule I got.
Yeah.
It's like, we came down here and I brought my laptop and stuff because I got people calling me constantly. Hey, we got these files, we got this and that. It's like, alright, yeah.
Yeah.
But it's good. It's a good problem to have.
It is.
It's a lot better than laying in bed at night wondering where you're going to get work,
uh-huh.
You know? I've been there, too.
Yeah, well, even when the pandemic hit us, it was a matter of, I drove Uber Eats. I mean, I was still new on the tour circuit,
right.
So to speak. I mean, these guys have been doing this stuff for like 20 years.
Yeah.
You know, I've been in this for two. You know, still learning the ropes.
Right.
The advertising and all that stuff. I just drove Uber Eats in between my smaller tours. I had smaller groups like this sporadically throughout the night, and then
right.
They shut us off. And then when they opened this back up, they said you could go to smaller groups, and I'm like, I'm already in smaller groups.
Right.
I got a roll over 10. I'm already sanitizing everything.
Right.
I'm already, I don't have to change.
Yeah, you're following all the protocols.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I mean, the only difference for me was the mask. I have epilepsy. I had a hard time going back
yeah.
And forth with the mask.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it was a little rough. Like,
yeah.
I got sick last summer before they tested for COVID. So, I was out a week for 3 more weeks.
Yeah.
So, it got a little rough there for a while.
Well, you get through it, and then it's like, come out on the other side, you
Once
know?
Once September hit, I mean, I've literally been nonstop.
That's awesome.
January was a little slow because I bought my end out of the company. The
right.
Stories in the cemetery name was already mine. I was just underneath an umbrella. And I just, you know, we made amends, and all right, thanks
yeah,
for showing me the ropes, I'm out.
Part your ways,
yep.
Yeah.
And, I mean, there was something wrong with a booking today, and the email went to him. He still sends it to me. He's not, you know, being a jerk about it.
Right.
We're still friendly, but I believe the price ticket. We're missing out.
Yeah.
We're really missing out.
Yeah.
I thought well, double the price tickets from when we started. We were
yeah.
Like $20 when we started.
Boy, you got to cover you. You got a lot in it besides just walking for a couple hours. You know,
right.
There's a lot of, and that's what people don't understand about a lot of stuff is you got a lot of stuff on the backside. You know?
Right. Yeah. I mean, insurance on this stuff.
Yeah.
Well, obviously, the cost of this stuff.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And keeping it going, the research you got to do.
Right. Well, and everything, like, all the stories you're telling us, I mean, you spend a lot of time on that part, you know. It's, but, I mean, you do a good job. I've enjoyed what we've done so far. I mean, I've had a great
started.
Time. Well, that's what I was telling Katie. I said, we have to definitely check out your podcast. I mean, I've really enjoyed it so far.
I took a year off so I could finish my master's degree. I got new episodes coming up September, October, because I just hired a co-host. So I'm training her to be on the mic. She's doing the research and the things for me. She actually works for an investigative team. So, like, she knows what all of this stuff is. She knows
right.
How it works. So it's going to be an easy discussion. I don't have to explain what things are.
Right.
So, with her, she's doing the back end. She's doing check and get her ready and her schedule align with the stars, you know, and just kind of see how it goes. I mean, people have been wanting more episodes. Because I know because they're still listening. They're still leaving reviews. And shit, I got to get back on this.
Yeah, for sure. And then, it just keeps somersault, you know, it's keep building on, building momentum.
That's all it is.
That's what
momentum.
It is. Yeah, exactly.
What are we getting over there?
Well.
Got them in your shoe, like you're tapping on your toe. How many books have you written?
I'm about to publish number 8.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. So is your books on your...
Everything's on the website or on Amazon. You can actually, there's a bookstore locally that carries them for me.
Oh,
so
okay.
I can send people up to them. I mean, I'm self-published. The wife does all the, you know, graphic stuff.
Right.
All the covers and all
right.
that stuff for me. Headshots, you know, my book signing and stuff like that. So
right.
Guys, I'm still busy with that too. But my thesis for my master's degree was a big novel.
Now is this fictional stuff that you
all fiction.
Oh, cool.
And it's all based on the Afterlife. So like Greek mythologies on the world. This one that I'm about to publish is Atlantis in the Afterlife.
Okay.
So again, it's kind of all over. I have a little novelette series that I publish in between my novels.
Right.
So they're just short little things,
that
quick
is cool.
books, but those are about reincarnation.
Well see, that's like Katie, she was a teacher for years and she's really good with like wording stuff. I have all these crazy ideas in my head and I've written a bunch of different stuff down and I've been trying to talk her in to help me like write it out, you know, because I mean it's I can get her through like the concept of everything, but then the verbiage and the vocabulary and she gets on me all the time. Like she's like, when you text me you never put a comma or a period, or I never use punctuation for anything. She's like, you gotta get better for that. But she's really good at it. I've been trying to talk her into hooking me up with that.
It did not sound good, did it?
No, it didn't sound good. Oh, that sounded like
an actual
explosion or something, yeah.
That sounded like a rifle.
Yeah. Yeah, that's weird.
As far as, like I've been writing, I'm 42. I wrote my first book when I was 19.
Oh, man.
It was horrible. I mean, it was pretty shit.
excluding anybody from anything. Yeah, that's awesome. That's what I've always been interested in this kind of stuff. And then Katie and I got together and I was telling her about it. We started watching some different shows and stuff or whatever, but then there's a couple companies I work for that used to be like old factories and stuff, and you'll be in those factories and stuff will happen.
Sure.
You know, and stuff you can't explain, you know. And I've told her about it, and then one of them actually have video footage of like doors opening and closing and there's nobody there, and you can see like light, you know, not dust, but you can actually see like light move, and it's erratic, you know. And I mean, they have really good evidence, but nobody really investigates or anything. And so I was telling her, I'd really like to learn more about it, just kind of like what you do, just to kind of get the backstory and figure out, okay, what happened here that's causing this thing.
Like, what I'm going to do.
Right, right.
And it's not that I know everything.
Right.
Yeah, I'm still investigating things.
Sure, yeah.
What we're going to do.
Yeah.
I don't know everything about that guy.
Yeah.
I know what the name of the newspaper was that he used to run. I know that he was an editor.
Right.
He was related to Charles.
Right.
That's all I know. We're going to go up there.
And then you start piecing it together and researching.
Right.
Yeah.
And just, honestly, the fit family was so huge down here. I know what he talks about.
Right.
And you can find, like, all kinds of historical societies that honor him all the time.
Yeah. And the history behind it is more interesting to me. Like, how did these things happen? What would transpire in these different locations that cause any kind of action? You know, I don't really care so much about somebody getting their head blown off or this or that. It's just like, to me, like, you're talking about all the cross-relating between the pirates and all that. It's like,
man, that's the only reason we're here is because this building would probably be one of the very few that's familiar to urban that time
period. Right, right. And I mean, and the history of that building is amazing, you know, you explaining that stuff. So it's really fascinating.
Again, without knowing that layout, or this was the Charles Tunnel.
Right.
That plantation was in Georgetown. You sent her down to the Long Diner.
Right.
To come do business, come sell the rice, come sell whatever they were making, and come bring it down here. So this building's familiar. That building's definitely not familiar.
No.
You know, Della Park and Broadway,
yeah.
1708.
Yeah.
So, again, it's just...
Well, her and I were talking about it, too. It's like... We've traveled a little bit this summer, different places, you know, down the East Coast, and you know, we've been to Savannah before and different stuff. But it was funny because like you can see some old buildings through here, but then you can tell where something happened and they've replaced them, and that's what we were talking about. You know, like that building right there is obviously old ass building, you know.
Like a triangle, right?
Yeah.
So that was actually part of the building. So after it was done serving wars, or in between serving wars, because it didn't always serve, it didn't always pull gunpowder. It was a mercantile, it was a textile, it was different
right.
businesses.